I'm Mike Warren. I'm a national consultant and road user in charge of emerging mobility. What that means is I work with our offices around the country to help their clients explore ways to do research studies and explore transitioning from a per gallon funding model to a per mile funding model, known as road user charge. Road user charging in the U.S. has been around for roughly the past two decades. States have been exploring transitioning to a per mile funding model as the gas tax is no longer sustainable. A per gallon funding model just cannot support the capital and operational needs that states have. So as states explore road user charging, which to date upwards of almost 40 states have explored something from a feasibility study to public outreach and communications, all the way through pilot studies to four legislatively authorized programs in the U.S. right now. States are starting to explore this because they realize that the per gallon funding model is no longer sustainable.
My name is Kary Witt, and I work in HNTB's national tolling and road pricing practice. We think we've probably seen the peak fuel sales in the U.S. So from here, it's all downhill in terms of potential revenue from fuel taxes. So it's clear something has to be done.
The time is now. Doing these feasibility studies, doing these pilot studies, rolling out these types of programs, exploring the impacts on electric vehicles as well as high fuel efficiency vehicles, determine their impact on the roadways, their impact and their contribution to the Highway Trust Fund, and then start developing programs that help bridge that gap between what vehicles should be paying and what vehicles are currently paying. The first thing is finding those legislative champions, finding those legislators that will support these types of initiatives. With every state that I've worked with, we've always found a legislative champion to help shepherd these initiatives through.
It is really important that a road user charge program be tailored to meet the specific needs of the community or the state that you're working in. What we're finding as we go out and talk about road user charge in the community is it's generally perceived as being a little bit more fair than some of these other revenue sources. And that is, you know, it's really based on your use of the roads. If you don't use the road at all, you don't pay anything. If you do use the road, the amount that you pay is directly proportional to how much you use the road.
Motorists have to understand how their roads are funded. They have to understand how this program will impact them. We've had motorists say that they're concerned that they're going to be paying hundreds of dollars more a month, and at the end of the day, most people are paying less. So by transitioning to this model, you have to educate and inform and really take the messaging down to what's the impact on the motorists.